Janasya Krishnad Vimukha Shadaivad Adharma Silasya Sudukhitasya Anugrahayeho Charantinunam Bhutani Bhavyani Janardanasya Janasya Krishnad Vimukha Shadaivad Adharma Silasya Sudukhitasya Anugrahayeho Charantinunam Bhutani Bhavyani Janardanasya Sisila Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Goswami Thakur Prabhupada told that this material world is a place. Sisila Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Goswami Thakur Prabhupada told this material world is a place where you can be tested by Mayadevi. Is a place of painful experiment on you. Is a kind of painful experiment. Painful experiment, testing on you, can be done by Maya. Srila Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Goswami Thakur Prabhupada speaking, if you can bear everything, if you can tolerate, if you can tolerate any kind of problem coming in this life, any kind of eventuality you are meeting, any kind of pain you are getting in this material world, you should bear, tolerate everything. Then and only then, you can go up. Otherwise, there is no question of cutting this material bondage, no question. You can remember, I already discussed about this point, how Mahabhagavat Vidurji Maharaj was insulted. How different way he was insulted all the time by Duryodhan and his group. Those who are insulting Guru Vaishnava, their condition we cannot speak out. They can suffer life after life. No solution they can get in their life. Big problem. Vidurji Maharaj Mahabhagavat, he was insulted by Duryodhan and his Guru in different way. But still, Vidurji Maharaj never losing his patience. Vidurji Maharaj never losing his patience. Strong patience. Because he wanted to render some causeless service to them, those who are fallen souls. So pure Vaishnava, they are never losing their patience. If they are insulted this way, that way, but still, because it is their only duty to deliver this common people, nothing else. They have no self-interest. So anyway, they are not at all going to lose their patience. At all, they are not going to lose their patience because they have no personal interest. Very good. They are pure sadhu, Vaishnava. Now, yesterday I was discussing about how this creation took place. You can remember how this creation took place here in this material cosmic world manifested. It's a very important thing. And I was discussing about how tamagun, tatta get distorted, how satagun tattva get distorted and get, those demigods, they are coming. Rajagun distorted, all your sense organ, everything develop. All your tamagun distorted, then how you can get this, khiti apotej marut bom. How you are getting. And I wanted to prove, it is also written in Chaitanya Charitamrita, Akasher Gunjano Paraparo Bhute. It's Bengali, but very important. I told you, this ether, space, which in Sanskrit and Bengali are speaking Akash. But actually it is ether, okay? And inside this ether is a very secret quality is there, it's called sound. I told you. When this Akash, the ether tattva get distorted, then Vayu and air creates. Inside the air, Sparshogun, Sparsho means touch, qualities also there. So I wanted to prove yesterday that each and every, step by step, if I go on, I can prove that in earth, after water, after that earth, you can get all the qualities that is there originally, everything you can get here. Consecutive, step you go up, you can the previous quality already inherited there, already inside. This way it is very fantastic. It's very fantastic that Bhagavan Sri Krishna speaking, I am omnipresent, but still I am not anywhere. I am staying in my in own glories, I am maintaining achyuta, my own position. And glories I can maintain, and I have some separate sarup, nitya sarup, eternal world. Though I am everywhere, it's very interesting. Second canto, when I was approaching the last chapter, almost 10, then I was discussing that Badrayanu Vacho, Badrayanu means the son of Badrayan Rishi, I mean Sukadev Goswami. Sukadev Goswami is speaking, and Sutadev Goswami giving quotation that what happened then, what he told in Naimish Kshetra. Now here point is that Badrayani Rishi wanted, now speaking, Atra sarga visargas chastanam pasanamutayo mannantaro ishanu katha nirodha mukti rasrayaha Atra sarga visargas sthanam pasanamutayu mannantareshanukatha nirodha mukti rasrayah. 10th canto, first sloka. 10th canto, first, second canto, 10th chapter, first. Atra sarga visargascha sthanam pasanamutayu mannantareshanukatha nirodha mukti rasrayah. Dasamasya vishudhyartham navanamiho lakshanam varnayanti mahatmanaho srutena arthena chanjasa. All nine kind of evidence given in favor of one and single and unique objective, that is called Advaita Gyan Tattva. Follow me. That is called Advaita Gyan Tattva. For towards this end, nine kind of evidence from different square we are going to prove. And what to be proved? But that is that the thing, ultimate thing, it is to be proved. The Krishna Tattva, the ultimate Tattva. Now we don't know what is called Sarga. Sargo visargascha sanam pasanam. What do you mean Sarga? I already told, from Karana Nama Vishnu, all the infinity cosmic manifestation took place. The overall from Mahatatya, when Mahatatya agitated, everything happens. Then the balance of Sato Raja Tamagun disturbed. Then the starting of creation is in a preliminary stage of creation. When this balanced situation of Sato-Raja-Tamagun disturbed, then everything problem, then after that, Mahatatya, because Bhagavan enter into Kal. Kal means time. After that, everything going to happen. So first of all, this cosmic manifestation took place in a big way. This overall cosmic manifestation is called Sarga. Overall cosmic manifestation is called Sarga. And Visarga, what do you mean by Visarga? Visarga means actually when Brahma took the responsibility by the power of Krishna to create some thing here in this material world, 14 world, in this specific Brahmanda. Follow. In this specific Brahmanda, when Krishna, when by Krishna, Brahma enjoying this facility, I mean power, then Brahma took the initiative, took the responsibility to create something here. This is, that is called actually Visarga. That is called Visarga. And actually, you see, sthan, sthan mean position and rank. Sthan mean, sthan, it mean position and rank. Position, position and rank of what? But those jiva created here in the material world, according to their activities, according to their dignity, improvement, they are giving some position by Krishna. It's an automatic factor. Because those who are demigods, they are getting much more facility than advantage. Those Rishi Muni, Gandharva, they are, so Rishi, Gandharva also. So as and when you are going up and up and up and up, they are in according to the improvement and upgradation done. They are going to get some rank and position specially approved by Krishna. It is called sthiti. It is called sthiti. And what do you mean by potion? Potion mean to take care. Krishna fostering potion. Bhagavan giving mercy, and Bhagavan is, you know, fostering them, taking care of them. So this call actually, so according to their position, they are being, you know, taken care by God. That's called potion. If Supreme Lord not taking care of us, how we can, we are getting air, water, you know, all food, grains, everything, all facility, we are maintaining our life. Those demigods, they are not getting any grains. When clarified butter is, you know, offered in fire, they get in some fruit there. This way, according to the great, they are getting facility. So it's called portion. And what do you mean by uti? Poshano mutayo. Utayom, mutayom in bahuvachan, uti single. When plural number is utayo, poshanam utayo. Mutayo means, you know, mutayo means, those jiva, they have some personal desire. According to personal desire, they are, you know, bound to do something. It's called actually karma samuhir basana. They always try to do something. That's called actually vasana, utayo. It's called utayo, mani uti. And manantaradi, I say, atro sarga visargascha sthanam pasana mutayo. I am discussing everything, poshano, mutayo. And after that, manantaro. Manantara means 14 manu coming. 14 manu, they are coming. See, this 14 manu, each manu, they are doing something, and according to the stage and condition, they are maintaining some dharma. They have some specific dharma, dhanna manantar. Each manu coming, they like to execute some dharma, like to do some, as they actually called manantaro. Manantaro is called manantaro. Or ishanu katha means, isho matlab Paradevata, Sikshna, Paratvara Akhileshwar. Okay? So, his glories, when you are going to discuss all about his glories, pastime, everything, it is called actually Ishanukatha. Ishanukatha means Isho Anukatha. Isho Anukatha means supreme, the glories of Krishna, the, you know, everything, Leela, but under the guidance of Guru Vaishnava, not breaking any rules of restriction, not breaking any rules of restriction set by our Guru Bhargava, we will have to follow Shautapantha. Shautapantha. Exactly what Guru Bhargava is speaking, I will have to speak, sing the glories and hear, actually. This way, Manantara Ishanukatha, this way. And Nirodho, Nirodho mean, when Supreme Lord, actually, after annihilation, Supreme Lord liked to sleep with Yoganidra. Yesterday I was speaking. Yoganidra, Bhagavan sleeping, that time actually, Bhagavan actually taking rest externally, inside Purna Gyan, full knowledge is there. Actually, the actual meaning of Nirodh, the actual meaning of Nirodh is to sleep in a very passive way, as if Supreme Lord not going to do anything, without any creation initiative. Sleep. All Yoga Maya, Maya, all Maya and power, putting inside and after the sleeping. That means no creation, nothing. Even no time is there. Even that time, no time factor you can get. Follow, you see. You cannot get time factor. Jaya 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 jayama yita dosa bigita guna tamasi yadatmana samabaruda samasta bhaga. This form, 10th canto, we can know. Jaya 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 yama yito dosa givito guna tamasiya dhatmana samabaruda samasta bhaga. Very nice. Samasta bhaga means all power, O Supreme Lord. You take up and put inside you and sleep without any action. Even that time, no time is there. No action, nothing. Only Supreme Lord. No creation, nothing, nothing. That is called actually Nirodh. It is called Nirodh. After that, Mukti. Nirodho Mukti Rasraya. Nirodho Mukti Rasraya. Mukti. Mukti means actually, you can find the meaning of Mukti as liberation. But actually, liberation, this term, we don't like to use. Mukti means those material, you know, those material man, they sometimes they say, we like to get Mukti, free from all material culture. They like to commit suicide. Suicide is not the solution. They like to commit suicide. Especially those foreign people should know. In European country, the, you know, number of, you know, suicide is more high, because they are getting frustration after they commit suicide. They are not getting anything, any actual meaning of life, because they are going just opposite way. That's why they should know this point, that to commit suicide means to commit great offense. It's not solution. You can never be excused by Supreme Lord. So after that, actually point is there. If I commit suicide, if I can solution, then everybody can commit suicide. Not solution. Then you can get big pain. All ghost, they are getting big pain. All the time crying. After that, you see, Avi Gauriya, those Mayavadi, they discuss this way. Mayavadi, they think, if we can do bhajan and submerge with this impersonal Brahman, then we can be saved. then there is no problem. There is no separate identity existence. There is no separate existence of Jivatma. But know it for sure. Nobody can prove that the existence of Jivatma can be extinct. Never. It is not possible. Always for infinity period, Supreme Lord is there, and Jivatma, all countless Jivatma, they are also there. Nobody can stop it. This relation, Jivatma, always countless Jivatma, infinity Jivatma. Some foreign devotee asking me sometime, Maharaj, if Jivatma is produced daily, production of Jivatma going on, and why you are putting question this way? Whereas I already told that Jivatma is infinity. Jivatma is infinity. The what the question of taking birth or not? I told you Jivatma is infinity. Infinity means you cannot count in infinity period. So why you put question? That means your finite conception coming. That's why you are asking this way. Not good. So all Jivatma, they are separate identity. All countless Jivatma, their separate identity is a must. Those Mayavadi want to go up and submerge with personal Brahman effulgence, but it is not permanent. Again they can fall down. Brahma speaking, na arujjakrichena param padam tatha patati adha anadrita jusmat angrayo. They ignore the eternal service of your lotus feet. That's why, though they are sometimes elevated, but still they fall down. But we go here, those are Vaishnava, those devotees, their Siddhanta is very perfect, scientific Siddhanta. I already told many times, Muktir Hitya Annatha Rupam, Muktir Hitya Annatha Rupam, Sarupena Vyavasthiti Hita Mukti. This jiva, for infinity period, traveling this material world, dying, and again take birth. Birth and death, birth and death. After that, by chance, if they get the association of pure Vaishnava, Brahmanda Bhramita Kono Bhagavan Jeev, Guru Krishna Prasade Bhai Bhakti Lata Bij. Brahmanda means, 14 words, you are traveling, by chance, if you get the association of pure Vaishnava, you can stop this cycle of birth and death. It's okay, finish. Now you can be attracted towards Krishna, His eternal service, and you can discover your sarup that I am the eternal servant of Krishna. You can automatically discover that what is my identity? I am the eternal servant of Krishna. That is called actually mukti. Mukti, actually not liberation mean. In English we say liberation, but this liberation term we don't like to use. It's not perfect. But still we are bound to use it. What to do? So, muktir hitya annatha rupam sarupena vyavasthiti iti mukti. And asraya. Asraya actually means shelter. Asraya mean, Sanskrit and Bengali, asraya mean mukti. Asraya mean shelter. Actually, all infinity world, Krishna is the only shelter. In this infinity world, Krishna is the only shelter of all Jivatma and everything. Not only Jivatma, all demigods, gods, they see money, all bonded soul for all. Krishna is the ultimate shelter of all, you know. Krishna is the ultimate shelter of all. That the very thing I wanted to prove in front of you. So that dasamastha, the tenth factor, all nine factor from different scriptures, from different different scripture we can collect evidence, and ultimately want to prove that Krishna is the ultimate goal. So this way we are, you know. This way we wanted to prove, and you know, the creation is very, very typical. Whole creation, you know, is very nice thing. Very typical, very complicated. How different kind of creation took place when human beings came, when peace to those beasts and trees, everything to all birds and, you know, everything took place, how and when. A big chapter, you see. So in gist, I wanted to speak in front of you. Still, in this third canto, also you can get some clue. And it is a big, huge chapter. Now, actually, we are going to step into third canto. So, Sukadev Goswami is speaking now. Sukadev Goswami now speaking, actually. Je evam etat pura prishtho maitriyo bhagavan kila khatra banam pravishten otyaktya sagriham riddhimat. Just the sloka I started with, you can remember. That Vidurji was insulted by Duryodhana and his group in different way, but still not losing his patience. when one day Vidurji Maharaj finding there is an extreme point. Actually, Vidurji Maharaj can't bear that extreme point also. But Vidurji Maharaj thought, if I am here, he can go on insulting me. So he can get a very bad result for that. So better I take leave. Extreme point doesn't mean that Vidurji Maharaj going to lose his patience. Not that. It was extreme because Vidurji Maharaj thought, if I am not going to leave this place, Duryodhan can go on insulting me and he is going to meet with very, very bad eventualities in near future. So better I leave this place. Anyway, they are not going to accept my advice. Vidurji is mantri, minister. Vidurji is minister, mantri mean, in English you say minister. But in Sanskrit we say, mantri mean giving advice, mantrona in Sanskrit. So Vidurji giving very, very nice, you know, advice in his whole life. It's a volume of book. Big advice. It's called Vaidurikam. We are speaking Vaidurikam. In whole life, Vidurji giving different kind of advice. Very nice. There is a compilation of all his advices, you know, we can make a nice book. It's called Vaidurikam. Very nice. So now, Vidurji Maharaj going to leave this, you know, kingdom forever. Useless living. He wanted to insult and throw him out. Actually, Duryodhan wanted to throw him out of this kingdom. But he is not getting such scope. Duryodhan wanted to throw him out of kingdom. But he is not getting such scope. Because before insulting, Vidurji Maharaj already leaving this place, night time, and traveling all different places in a pilgrimage. And ultimately, actually, Vidurji Maharaj, all on a sudden, meeting with Uddhavji Maharaj. Uddhavji Maharaj ki jai, is meeting with Uddhavji Maharaj. Now, Uddhavji Maharaj, they embrace each other, love each other, because both of them are the, you know, dearmost and of Supreme Lord. You know, they love, you know, Supreme Lord, you know, a personal associate of Supreme Lord, actually. So, Vidurji Maharaj meeting Uddhavji Maharaj, and now Parikshit Maharaj asking this question, he was speaking that, Vidurji Maharaj going to leave his kingdom, and going for different, you know, pilgrimage. After that, ultimately he is going to meet with Maitreya Rishi. But where he meet? He is going to put question, who? Who? Parikshit Maharaj. Parikshit Maharaj is saying, acha, where actually Vidurji Maharaj meeting with Maitreya Rishi? We like to get detailed information. It's very excellent question. Because we can get a nice answer of Bhagavad Katha. So this way actually is going to describe, I mean, Raja, I mean Parikshit Maharaj, asking this question this way. Parikshit Maharaj, out of his own experience, previous experience, he heard something. He is going to describe. Because Vidurji Maharaj, about Vidurji Maharaj, Parikshit Maharaj hearing all from his fathers, you know, five, I know, grandfathers. Parikshit Maharaj hearing everything. Because Vidurji Maharaj very friendly with Panchapanda. He's getting all information, how different way he was insulted, what kind of treatment done by Duryodhan, this, that, and where, how he went out before, you know, Kurukshetra battle, Yudhya, before this Kurukshetra battle, I mean, he, where? Going out. So this way, actually, now Parikshit Maharaj giving, out of his own emotion, speaking all about what happened in the life of, Viduji Maharaj, and repenting. He was insulted this way, he was expelled, oh God, is so big devotee, this way. Now, in the meantime, we see, it's the own feeling of Parikshit Maharaj, expressing this big discussion. He is expressing, he was insulted this way, nice devotee, this way, everything. So after that, actually, Sukadeva Goswami, in the second chapter of third canto, we find Sukadeva Goswami Vacho iti bhagavataho prishto khatra vartam priyasrayam pratibhaktum cha pratibhaktum cha sehe utkanta smarite swara iti bhagavatah prishtha khatya bartam priyasrayam pati baktum na cha utsehe utkanta smarite swara. When this way they meet with each other, I mean Vidurji Maharaj and Uddhavji, they embrace each other, they are crying out of love and ecstatic feeling. Then Sukadeva Goswami speaking, Bhagavat, devotee Bhagavat, because Gonta Bhagavat, Book Bhagavat and Bhakta Bhagavat, Iti Bhakta Bhagavat Khatra, when Vidurji Maharaj asking some question to Uddhavji Maharaj, but Uddhavji Maharaj is not at present now, not at all in a position to give answer, because he is full of love and ecstatic feeling, almost, sattik bhav. He is feeling so nice feeling, and tears, rolling down his cheeks. He cannot give answer. His throat, his voice is just choked up. He cannot speak out. Because Sukadeva Goswami is speaking, he is so nice devotee, Uddhava is so excellent devotee, how he can speak? Because Parikshit Maharaj, Vidurji Maharaj asking all about Krishna. So already, always the feeling of Krishna is already there. Whenever Vidurji Maharaj is asking directly about Krishna, then as if he is feeling, disturbed. Disturbed means, he is remembering Krishna so strongly, he is unable to speak out. His throat choked up. This way. Because from childhood, from birth, he was a great devotee. From childhood, he was a great devotee. In the childhood, when mother used to call, "Oh my son, come and take your breakfast." Son, no, I have no time. Why? I am playing. Playing, what playing? He's worshipping Krishna, getting flower and fruits, everything, offering to Krishna, giving garlands, this kind of playing, you see. I have no time, mother. I cannot go. But when, you know, he remembered Krishna so strongly, then after some time, you know, he get over, wanted to get over this situation, I mean, in which he is now put it into. Great feeling. After that, gradually he opened his eyes, very gradually, and started answering. Started answering to Vidurji Maharaj. Now Uddhavji Maharaj somehow check up himself, control, and now going to give answer to Uddhavji Maharaj. So he is crying and speaking this sloka. Uddhavji Maharaj Vacho 7. Krishna jodumani nimloche girneshu ajugareṇah kingnu no kusalam bruyam gato srishu griheshu aham. What to speak about, hena, about, you know, the Krishna and Jodhu destiny. How to speak? You are speaking about how they are. You are speaking, oh Biduji, you are asking how they are. Please say, they are okay or not? Eh? How to speak? Because Krishna gone. Krishna gone? Yes. Krishna, the sun, the great sun, set. Like sunset. Krishna, Jadumani, Jadumani meaning total Jadu destiny, he was a jewel. Krishna jodumani nimloche girneshu ajagarenaha kingno kusalam bryam gato srishu griho griheshu aham. And like python, you know, ajagar. As if ajagar already everything, all goods, I swallow, all gone, everything. You are losing everything. As if one ajagar, you know, python, you know, swallow everything, all gone. What you are asking about their good? They are okay or not? Everything gone. Everything gone? Yes. Everything gone. Now, over and again, non-stop, I am remembering Krishna. I cannot just resist myself from crying. I am crying all the time. I lose Krishna. You know, now I again and again I remember about his past Leela. When Krishna was with us, all the time, now I remember and crying. How, you know, big fallacy. How much is Maya, Krishna, Jogo Maya. Everybody is staying with Krishna. They know that Krishna is Supreme Lord, but they still cannot feel it. They know Krishna is the Supreme Lord, everybody knows, but they cannot feel it. They are joking with Krishna, playing with Krishna, playing some trick with Krishna. Kita Barma and everything, they are playing trick with Krishna. You know? Satyajit Raja, they are not at all ready to give that jewel, Samantak money, to Krishna. Playing trick with Krishna, whereas they are aware of the thing. Krishna is the Supreme Lord. We should not play with Krishna. But still, it's so Maya illusion. Jogo Maya. You know, this way you see. Now, Vidurji Maharaj remembering, Vidurji Maharaj repeatedly, he can remember his past. Leela, is that Krishna, Supreme Lord? You know, he used to call me Uddhav. Please come, some problem happens, you see. Can you give me advice what to do? Uddhav, no crime, come on. He is the Supreme Lord, having full knowledge, you know. Yanmadasya yato anmayadita rascharthe su sabhigya sarat. He is sabhigya. In infinity world, all different kind of knowledge, everything coming from Krishna. Yasmin gyatye sarvam idam vigyatum bhavati. Yasmin prapte sarvam idam praptum bhavati. That is called totality. The complete is there with Krishna, but still he used to, Uddhav, some problem happened. What to do in this situation? Could you give me advice about this? So now I'm crying, he is Supreme Lord, he used to call me. Uddhav, come, give me advice. Who am I to give him advice? Now I can remember. I was so foolish, I used to come, I used to go to him and used to give advice. Prabhu, as present, I think you should go there and first of all, Jarasandha should be killed. This way, Uddhav giving advice to Krishna. So nice. Krishna, now remembering the beauty of, you know, Uddhavji Maharaj, now remembering all the beauties of Krishna. So nice looking, super personality. Krishna, if you look any single limb, you know, anga pratyanga, any one limb, if you see the finger of Krishna, you can stand still, you cannot move your eyes. So nice. If you look at the lotus feet of Krishna, you cannot move your eyes. Fix. So nice Krishna. And not only that, but also Uddhavji speaking, to Krishna himself become hypnotized, go mad. When he look his own picture in, you know, pillar, his own pillar, you know, pillar, made up, you know, so nice jewel, you know. Whenever Krishna moving inside the palace, you know, sometime Krishna looking, who is he? Krishna standing in front of a pillar, or, you know, nice jewel. Krishna looking at his own picture. Who is he? I like to kiss him. Are you? Krishna himself, looking at himself. I want to kiss and embrace. Who is he? You cannot believe. Me? Yes. Janmarto lilopi kamsa yogam. Mayavalam darsayata grihitam bismahapanam sasva chasauvagardhe parampadam bhushana bhushanangam janmarto lilopayikam sajogam mayavalam darsayata grihitam bismahapanam sasva chasauvagardhe parampadam bhushana bhushanangam 12, number 12, second chapter. Yes, actually, by the mercy of Jogmaya, so, you know, Uddhavji speaking is wonderful. Krishna himself become hypnotized. So this kind of wonderful thing, unparalleled, unbeaten, this kind of beauty cannot be compared. Unparalleled, unbeaten. Yan marto lilo upayikam saju. Jan marto lilo upayikam sajoga mayavalam darsayatagrihitam. How, Uddhav speaking, how it was possible to look at Mahaprabhu Krishna? How? Can you see Krishna? If suppose Krishna is standing here, can you see Krishna? I told this Siddhanta, you can remember. Suppose Krishna is standing here, you cannot see. Because to see Krishna, you need to enjoy some kripa, some sakti. It is called saprakasata, self-expression power. When Krishna wants to express himself in front of you, then and only then you can see. Saprakasata. In Sandarbha, Jiva Goswami Pada writing, it is called saprakasata sakti. Saprakasata sakti, self-expressing. Krishna's countless shakti is there with Krishna. Krishna, countless shakti, but this is also one kind of shakti. So Krishna wanted to, by the magic spell of Jogamaya, Krishna wanted to express himself in front of this, you know, human being in this material world. Whenever Chaitanya Mahaprabhu coming down here in this material world from Golok, then everybody can see Krishna. But they can see Chaitanya Mahaprabhu? No. Chapal Gopal also watching the everyday Mahaprabhu going to take bath. But that is not actually darshan. But anyway, you have the facility to take darshan of Mahaprabhu, Gauranga. Because anyway, he is coming down here in this material world as a human being. Anyway, you have the facility now. But when Krishna go up and climb is eternal abode, then also you have not that kind of facility. You cannot have. Though that darshan is not okay, but still you have the facility. Chapal Gopal watching daily. Though that is not darshan. When your tattva gyan giving full backing, that is called actual darshan. Follow what I say. When your tattva gyan giving you full backing, then your darshan is perfect. Otherwise, Krishna coming in front of you, still you cannot see Krishna. Sarvabhauma Bhattacharya all day and night watching Mahaprabhu. But still he cannot believe that he is Supreme Lord. But by the mercy of Gopinath Acharya, Mahaprabhu was bound to express himself in front of Sarvabhauma Bhattacharya. In front of Sarvabhauma Bhattacharya, Mahaprabhu was bound to express his own feature. When he expressed six hands, everything, then after that, Sarvabhauma Bhattacharya go faint, fall down. Sarvabhauma Bhattacharya fall down. So every day Sarvabhauma Bhattacharya watching. Every day Sarvabhauma Bhattacharya watching Gauranga Mahaprabhu. Every day. But he cannot realize. When Gopinath Acharya wanted to give some scriptural evidence, then Sarvabhauma Bhattacharya become very angry. Hey, what is the evidence? You speak, he is Supreme Lord? Useless? Useless. You actually cannot see, he is Supreme Lord? Whenever Prabhu can give you full kiba, then and only then you can understand. What speaking Mahaprabhu in Chaitanya Charitamrita? Gopinath Acharya was speaking. Ishwarer kipales hoyto jahare. Ishwarer kipales hoyto jahare. Shei to Ishwar tattva janibare pare. Only he can understand the tattva of Ishwar, Supreme Lord, when he is going to unveil his mystery. Like Brahma. Jabanaham yatha bhava yad rupa guna karmakha tataiva vijnanam astu te madanugrahat. Otherwise not, by his personal endeavor, effort, you cannot come out successful. So now, you see, this way actually, Supreme Lord can come. If he is standing here, maybe, he cannot see. Because Krishna is not going to express himself, have some kind of power, shakti, through which Krishna can express himself in front of your eyes. Though material eyes cannot see Krishna. Materialize, you cannot see Krishna. But still, Uddhavji crying and speaking, Janmarta lila upayikam sayogam mayavalam darsayata grihitam vismapanam sasacha sauvagarde parampadam bhushana bhushanangam. Uddhav speaking, we got this facility to see Krishna all day and night, you see. And all the ornament, all the jewel in the body of Krishna, all different kind of ornament and jewel, crown, everything, actually they are not going to increase the taste of Krishna. I mean, when you look at Krishna, it's not going to give some extra glamour to Krishna. On the contrary, those ornaments and, you know, jewel, they are getting honor on behalf of Krishna, that they are there. They have the luck to stay with the body of Krishna. They are lucky. They are not going to get some extra, you know, increase the, you know, beauty of Krishna. This way, Uddhavji, now crying and speaking all about what he is feeling, is deep feeling. Uddhavji now go on crying and speaking all about it, you know, direct feeling. What is feeling? All about the past. That Krishna is Supreme Lord. He took birth in Golo. He took birth in, you know, Mathura. And now he gone to Gokul. In the fear of Kamsa. Gone. Somehow he escaped there. And somehow they born and brought up there. After that he again, you know, killed so much, you know, Asura, Pitona, Adi. After again coming Mathura, going to Guru Griha in the school. He's going to Sandipani Muni school to take lesson about 64 different kind of, you know, Vidya. Oh God. After that coming back and praying, you know, in front of father and mother from Gokul when coming, then enter when Kamsa is gone, Kamsa is over, and the problem of Kamsa is over, he killed Kamsa. After that enter the, you know, jail and praying, oh father and mother, we took birth from you, but we could not take care of you. Very sorry we are. And but because we the Kamsa was there, so we couldn't come to you to do some seva. Anyway, this way he's going on speaking about his own feeling. At the same time, we are going to get one picture of Krishna's all lila in nutshell, very short, very small. Compares, we are going to get the whole picture of Krishna lila here by Uddhava. And the same sloka I told you, you can remember two sloka. Vyasji Maharaj advising to a student, he going to forest to arrest, you know, Sukadev Goswami, not physical arrest. So Sukadev Goswami, you can remember Sukadev Goswami came here in front of Vyasdev. Then two sloka I told. Vyasdev Goswami wanted to get his son Sukadev Goswami back so that he can speak Bhagavatam, this Bhagavad Ras, you see. And Sukadev Goswami is the, you know, it's a nice pot in which he can put this Bhagavad Rasa. That time two sloka I told you, you can remember this two sloka. Baraha piram natavaravapu karnayo karnikaram Vidyadvasakanakakupisambayayantinchamalam Randhanu venu radurasudaya purayana gopabrindai Vindaranam sapadaramanam pravishadgitakirti. Another sloka. Aho vokiyam stanakalakutam jighansaya apayayat jaddapiyat asadhi leve gotim dhatruchitam Tato anyam kangbadayalum saranam brajima. Whom to take shelter except Krishna, who is so excellent quality that Putana wanted to give, you know, breast, but actually poison was there. Kalkut wanted to kill in the form of, you know, in the guise of mother he came, but actually the motive of Putana was to kill. But that Krishna was so merciful, but still Putana wanted to kill Krishna, but Krishna was so merciful. Anyway, he sees coming, approaching me in the form, in the guise of mother. Anyway, I am going to give you excellent gati. Very nice. This way actually is giving nice picture of, you know, Krishna Leela. Even in third chapter also, Uddhavji going on speaking all about the past Leela in gist. You know, in gist is going on speaking this way. So after that, you know, this, you know, Vidurji Maharaj requesting him, could you give me this the transcendental knowledge, Dibha Gyan? which you got from Krishna at the time of disappearance. Uddhavji Maharaj speaking. Uddhavji Maharaj speaking. Actually, point is there that at the time of disappearance, I was there. I got the knowledge from Krishna. But you are supposed to get this knowledge from Maitreya Muni. I cannot act as a guru. Follow this Siddhanta, nice. Uddhavji not going to speak. Why? Uddhavji thinking, if I speak Bhagavad Tattva Vigyan, he can treat me as guru. I cannot act as guru. Because Vidurji is my senior. Those devotees, they are paying honor to each other. He is senior to me. I should pay. No, no. You are senior. No. This is so Vidurji Maharaj requesting that, could you give this knowledge to me? Well, you can get. But actually, I was there at the time of disappearance, Krishna speaking everything, Bhagavad Tattva Vigyan. But also, that time, Maitreya Muni was there. Maitreya Muni was there, present. So, my Prabhu, Supreme Lord Krishna, also he was speaking very nicely in front of Maitreya. I think he can act as your guru. You wait. Somehow you can meet Maitreya Muni, because Maitreya Muni was inspired by Krishna to give this knowledge to you. Is the instruction by Krishna. Instruction of Krishna. So somehow you can meet Maitreya Muni. You wait. After that, Uddhavji Maharaj actually. Uddhavji Maharaj wanted to take leave. Why? Because before leaving this material world, it was a strong instruction to who? Uddhav. Uddhav, you must go to Badrinarayan, the hilly place, Himalayan place. You can go to Badrinarayan and do some astrology and finances there. Wait there. You cannot go, Prabhu, I cannot live without you. Please take me with you. I cannot live even a fraction of a second. Uddhav, you love me? Yes, I love you. Without you, you will have to live. Because I like to keep you here in this material world as my representative guru. You are the fittest person. You will have to stay here. You will have to stay in this material world. It's my order. Don't try to break it. Go to Badrinarayan. Then Uddhav is crying. I'm bound to follow Krishna. How he can break? That time the sequence, the situation, you know, Uddhavji Maharaj speaking. Samabhadatam virajam prasanta runolochanam. Dovis chaturvir viditam pita kaushambarena cha bamo urau adhisritya dakshinangri saru ruham and opasritya arvaka arvak ashatya ashatyam akrisham taktya pippalam. Well, actually, syama vadatam virajam prashant arunalochanam dorbhis chaturbhir viditam pito kaushayambarena cha. Pitambar means a golden color, cloth. Shyamavadatam, so nice color of body. You know, like jewel. You know. You are sitting very peacefully, prasanna bhajan. Prashanta Arun Lochanam. Arun means Krishna's eyes is little red color inside. And so nice, very peacefully, and his, you know, this feet, this way. And he was, you know, sitting very calm and quiet, very peacefully, under, you know, one pippalavi, you know, actually pippal. Sri, one Ashatabhikya. No, this way. After that, you see, when I was searching, when Jaduvamsa, all they gone. Jaduvamsa, they are fighting with each other. They are all gone from this material world. Only four or three, they are rest, you know. Then after then, I am searching like mad. Where my Prabhu is? Where my Prabhu? Everywhere I am searching. All of a sudden, I find, oh, Prabhu is there. Distant place, very peacefully. Nobody is there. Like the topmost yogi, Krishna sitting. I search him and crying and fall down his lotus feet. Prabhu, you are here? Prabhu, very, very, you know, very harsh, very humble way, speaking. Actually, I am going to leave this material world. Actually. So, by that time, Maitreya Muni was also there. So, in front of, you know, Supreme Lord, they are all sitting. And Prabhu speaking all different kind of, you know, Tattva Siddhyanam. Jnanam Param Man Mahima Vabhasam Yat Surayo Bhagavatam Badanti. Those Surayo, Surayo mean not only demigods. Sur mean in Sanskrit word, Sur mean demigods. But here actually not demigods. Here all in total. Surya mean Dibba Suri. Those who are having their, you know, big knowledge. So actually, those Surajat Surayo Bhagavatam Badanti. That Bhagavat Tattva Vigyan, now I am going to speak in front of you. Try to accept it. And then Supreme Lord, you know, speaking all in details in front of this, you know. So after that you see, after that receiving this, you know, I am speaking. When Krishna already gone, then after that traveling, on a sudden meeting with Vidurji Maharaj. I am now speaking about how Krishna lived this material world. After that he meet with, I was speaking about this, that how Vidurji Maharaj meeting with Uddhavji, and Uddhavji speaking all about his past experience, everything, all Krishna Lila, all in gist, this way. Now, after that, Uddhavji going away. Uddhavji now going away because Vidurji going this direction, Uddhavji going this direction. He is going towards north, Badrikasam. It is the instruction of Bhagavan Sri Krishna. But one topmost secret Siddhanta is there. When we can discuss sometime in future, we can discuss the glorification of Srimad Bhagavad Gita Mahapuran from Skanda Puran, not from Padma Puran. We already discussed from Padma Puran. When we can discuss from Skanda Puran, there we can prove that actually Uddhavji Maharaj, he is going to stay there in Badrikasram, also he is going to stay in Vrindavan. Both. This Siddhanta I can speak, very topmost Siddhanta. Uddhavji Maharaj, one sarup, he is going to stay in Badrinaran still today. And in another sarup, he is going to stay there in Govardhan and Vrindavan, Uddhav Kunda. He is still there. Nobody knows. So this way, actually, now, Uddhavji Maharaj taking leave. Vidurji Maharaj going this way. Uddhavji Maharaj north direction, traveling, going, walking. I am going to Vidurji Badrinaran. In the meantime, Vidurji Maharaj somehow traveling, and you know, at the bank of Ganga, he meeting Maitreya Muni waiting there. Sukadeva Goswami speaking that Vidurji Maharaj found Maitreya Muni already waiting for him at the bank of Ganga. So Sukhdev Goswami in the fifth chapter speaking, Dari Dunadya Risabo Kurunam Maitreya Namasid Magadabudham Khatropo Sritya Chutabhava Siddhyo Prapacho Sausillo Guna Vitipta Dari Dunadya Dari Dunadya Dari Dunadya Mane Hear me very attentive. Fifth chapter. Dari Dunadya. Very, those words very innumining. Dwari, Dari mean gate, Dar. Dari Dunadya. Du mean Sargo. Sargan Nodi Kunta. Ganga. Eh? So, Dari Dunadya Risabo Kuruna Maitreya Maitreya Masin. Maitri Mahasina Magadha Bodham. So this means Haridwar. Dari Dunadya Risabho Kurunam. You know, Maitri Mahasina Magadha Bodham. Agadha Bodham means his intellectuality of Prakito, and he is so much. It's great, touching the lotus feet of Krishna all the time. Not material intellectuality. Many times I told in Harikatha, you know, you cannot, you know, touch the lotus feet of Krishna. Material people, they think we are intelligent. It's a prakita intelligence, you know. Oh, he's meeting Biduji Maharaj now meeting Maitreya Muni. And is very, very appealing mood. Very appealing mood in front of, you know, Maitreya Muni paying dandavat. And he is speaking all about his own feeling. And putting some questions so that Harikatha can come out. So that Harikatha can... First he is speaking her own feeling. Here is the situation of this whole world. In this situation I like to put some question. What? Biduji Maharaj now speaking out his own feeling. Own feeling. So I can speak two or three or four sloka, you try to hear. Vidurubacha in front of Maitreya Muni. O Rishivar, Sukhayo karma nikaroti loko natoi sukham vyanyat uporamamba bindetabhuyas tato eva duksham jadatra yuktyam bhagavan badinna. You know, very small, you know, humble way he is asking this question. You see, this material world, they are working whole day and night to get some enjoyment. To get some enjoyment. Why people putting so much energy? What for? To get some extra facility, enjoyment. Sukhayo karmani karoti loko. Karmani mean? Why people were so working so hard? Sukhayo karmani karoti loko. Why people working so much? To get some extra facility, enjoyment. I can lead my very peaceful life, very, you know, enjoy, I can enjoy my life. But why then they are getting pain? They are working hard, they are trying day and night to get some enjoyment. But why they are getting so much pain? They are not expecting any kind of pain in their life, but still coming. According to their past, you know, activity, the good and bad coming in their life. According to their past activities, good and bad coming in their life. What to do? They cannot stop. You know, their miseries, you see, they are bound to get. So, Biduji Maharaj, first putting question, Sukhaya karma nikaroti loko natoi sukham banyat uparamamba bindet bhuyas tato eva duksham jadatra yuktyam bhagavan badinyo janos krishna devimukho sadaivat. janasya krishnad vimukhasya daivad adharma silasya sudukhitasya anugrahaiho charanti nunam bhutani bhavyani janardanasya janasya krishnad vimukhasya daivad adharma silasya sudukhitasya anugrahaiho charanti nunam bhutani bhavyani janardanasya. Those who are the personal associate of Krishna, Supreme Lord, they have no personal interest, but still they are moving here and there to get some chance to deliver some bonded soul. They want to get some chance to get, to deliver those bonded soul. Janasya Krishnat Bhimukasya Daivad. Those who are bonded soul, they are averse to Krishna. They never like to hear about Krishna. They never like to do something about Krishna. So janasya krishnat vimukasya daivat, they are adharma. They are doing all sinful activities. Adharma silasya sudukhitasya. So automatically adhatik tap, adhatik, one kind of burning condition, always going there inside their heart. They are not getting any peace. So anugrahaiho noit for sure. Those, devotees of Supreme Lord, they are traveling here in this material world. To deliver them, anugrahaiho charanti nunam bhutani bhavyani janardanasya. Those are the personal associate of Krishna, Supreme Lord. They are coming to give some service to you, to make you free from this material world. Maya. But still, we common people so unlucky, we cannot understand. This way, Bidurji Maharaj putting so much question in front of, Maitriya Muni. Bidurji Maharaj putting so much question, nice question in front of, about Sishtatta, about Bhagavat Tattva, so many things. this way actually, Sukadeva Goswami now speaking, evam sa Bhagavan Prishta Khatta Kousharabhu Manihi Pungsam Nisriya Swarthena Tam Aho Bhumanayana. When Vidurji Maharaj speaking out his own feeling in front of Maitriya Muni and putting some nice question so that he can get more and more realization in his life. This way actually, Maitriya Muni giving honor to this kind of question. Well, very good. Very nice question. Because this question is unique and universal question. You are putting such question so that I am bound to give answer. So automatically Bhagavad Katha can come out. This way. Now, Maitri Muni would like to give answer. Maitri Uvacho. Maitri Muni now speaking. Sadhu prishtam taya sadhu lokano sadhu anugrinata. 18. Fifth chapter 18. Sadhu prishtam taya sadhu. Yes, ho sadhu. You are putting a nice question, excellent question. Sadhu prishtam taya sadhu lokano sadhu Swadhu unnu grinnatam. To give some benefit to this material world. Kirtin bitanvata loke atmano adokhaya atmanaha. So I am bound to speak out all about this, tattva vijnan. It is not, surprising. Because your name is Vidur. Maitri Muni speaking. It is not surprising on my part. You are putting so excellent question. Because your name is Vidur. You are the son of Vedavyas. I know. You cannot hide yourself. Noita chitram toi khattor badrayana birjaje. It is not, you know, surprising that you are putting such question in front of me. Noita chitram toi khattor badrayana birjaje. Grihit ananna bhavena yattaya haririswaraha. You have already accepted Krishna from heart. I know your identity. You are actually, your name is Vidur. You are the son of Badrandisi. We know. See, we already accepted Krishna from heart. So actually, you are putting such question. I am not actually, it is not surprising. Actually, your name is actually Jamaraj. Out of 12 Mahajan, you are one of them. How you came here in this material planet? Actually, I already told you. By the curse of Mandapa Muni, you are bound to come here in this material planet to stay here for 100 years. Only 100 years. Only 100 years you are going to stay here. Your name is Jamaraj. You are knowing everything. Aham betti, suko betti. This look. Very good. You know, this way actually, now Mandapa Muni, by the curse of Mandapa Muni, he was bound to come here in this material planet and stay here for 100 years. So long, Jamaraji Maharaj coming here in this material world to act and to play in the role of Biduji Maharaj, and so the heavenly planet there, Jamdwar, this is his room, is this place is vacant. Very nice. So anyway, you see, now Biduji Maharaj, you know, Maitreya Muni wanted to speak something about this Sishti Tatya, what I already told you. Mahat tattyat vikurvanat, aham tattyam bajayate. I already told you, in gist. From that mahat tattya, what do you mean by mahat tattya? Mahat tattya means the possibility of this creation. A creation, possibility of this creation. As called mahat tattya. When mahat tattya get disturbed, first of all, Krishna, you know, entering into time, the factor. Krishna, what Krishna doing first? Kal tattya adhishthan. Kal tattya means time. Krishna, you know, trying to insert himself in this factor, time factor. Then after that everything get disturbed. I mean, creation going to start. Balancing, you know, satura-jitama disturb, then after that mahat-tattva create, after that they, you know, see, from mahat-tattva, this, you know, this satagun disturb, rajagun disturb, and tamagun disturb, and from mahat-tattva, first of all, from mahat-tattva, one aham-tattva. Aham tattya means the adhidevota of aham tattya is Sankarsan. Adhidevota of this aham tattya is Sankarsan. Aham tattya means have some, not false ego like you. This ego is very nice. Very nicely in adjusted condition, staying with Sankarsan. In you, if this aham tattva staying, you are disturbed. But in Sankarsan, when this aham tattva taking is very adjusted way. This aham tattva also staying in Mahadev, the goddess of destruction. Ultimately, the total annihilation, destruction and annihilation done by Shankarsan. When total, you know, destruction, the time of, then the fire coming out of, fire coming out of Sankarsana, fire. Then all the fire coming out of the face of Sankarsana, all burnt up. So mahatatyad vikurvana bhaja mahatatyad vikurvanad ahang tattam bhajayati. After that, vastu, matter, you know, action, everything coming. All, you know. After that, how it is created, I already told you, you know, this way, different way I told you. So, if I go to discuss this point again, it will not permit me. The time is very limited. So, so much thing to discuss. But one very vital Siddhanta here, after this cosmic creation, then Bhagavan, you know, giving instruction to those demigods, try to, you know, try to start everything, creation. Those demigods, they are coming in, they are praying in front of Supreme Lord. We cannot do anything. Why? In front of Supreme Lord, those demigods, they are saying, Prabhu, we are undone, we cannot do anything. Why? All facility I give. All facility I give you. Why you cannot? We don't know, we cannot do anything, we are undone. We are undone. We are useless, we are, you know, in this situation. Then, Devata, all demigods, they are praying in front of Supreme Lord to get some power to start their respective duties. Okay, so I can speak one or two, you know, prayer, one or two prayer by those demigods. The Deva Uchu, Sri Deva Uchu, 39, you know. Nanamate Deva Padar Bindam Prapannatapo Po Samatopatram Nanamate Deva Padar Bindam Prapanno Tapopo Samatopatram Jan Muloketa Yatayo Anjasa Uru Sangsara Duksham Bahirut Kipanti Jan Muloketa Yatayo Anjasa Uru Sangsara Duksham Bahirut Kipanti Nanamo te deva, he dev, we pay dandava to you. Nanamo te devo padarabindam. That padarabindam, the lotus feet, you know, is just sufficient to give shelter. It's a shelter. Prapannatapo po shamat patram. Those who are inclined to you, it is just like umbrella. Umbrella protecting us from sunlight, from rain. And of prapanno tapu po samato patram. Atopatram mean umbrella. Your lotus feet, we are getting so much facility, you know. Janmula keto yatayo. Yatayo yati. Those who are busy with Supreme Lord, always thinking. They are throwing this material sangsar. If there is any burning feeling inside the sangsar, they can take it out and throw. Whoa! Because Krishna is there inside me. Who can do what? Problem. Nobody can do any problem. Because Krishna's lotus feet is there. I have no burning sense. I am always feeling very nice, peaceful. What problem there? You see, Nanamate Devo Padarabindam Prapannatapopo Samatapatram Janmulaketa Jatayo Anjaso Uru Sangshar Duksham Bahirut Kipanti. They throw out this burning condition. Go out forever. And no burning set. This way, actually, Deva Uchu, when they are Deva Devota, those demigods, they are praying in front of Supreme Lord, big way. Supreme Lord become very sad. What happens? Actually, we cannot do our respective duty. Why? I give everything. Still we cannot do. We don't know why. We don't know why we cannot do. Oh, okay. Then Supreme Lord, what doing? Supreme Lord entering into all tattva. Bhagavan Supreme Lord now taking entry into all tattva. Then after that, the demigod, they are giving, oh, now it's okay. Then now they can find some rhythm. Now they say, they can get some rhythm. Like in this material world, you can see, sometimes winter coming, sometimes spring coming, sometimes summer coming, sometimes rainy season coming. How? It's one kind of rhythm. After Baishak, we are buying, oh, mango in tree. So nice. After that, this way, all the rhythm. Huh? Everything going? Huh? How? Who is doing? Nobody knows. This material idiot people, they don't know who is the doer behind everything. Huh? So, those demigods are praying in front of Supreme Lord. Supreme Lord laughing. You cannot do? No, yeah, and we don't know why we cannot do any. We cannot take an initiative. We are undone. All facility you are giving, but still we cannot be, cannot take any action. What problem? Then Krishna says, okay, wait. Then Krishna enter into all tattva. Eh? After that, they again getting all facility, all mechanism started. When Krishna enter into all this tattva, then they are getting some rhythm. Oh, now okay. Like I can give one example, you see, very careful. I can give one example. One big factory is there. Big factory set up. And in big factory, there is factory manager, supervisor, all thousands of labor, they are ready to do some job there in factory. And production not yet started. Raw material there. All facility there, all machinery and everything, everything there. All everything. But all everybody coming in front of managers thinking, we cannot stop here, start our job. Why? We get all facility to you, all raw material there, labor there, foreman there, you know. Why? But we don't know why. But the manager, current is not there. If current is not there, if everything is there, what he can do? Current is not there, machinery is there, raw material there, all facility there, but there is no current. Now give the main switch, cut. Then actually current going, then all started. The Supreme Lord is the life of everything. Follow, you see, the example is the topmost example, you see. Everything facility, but nothing can be done because there is no current. So, Krishna is the life of everything. So now you see this way, Virat Srishti, the cosmic manifestation took place. After that, I already told you that Brahma, you know, also, you know, started his own creation. He received, you know, power from Krishna and started his own creation. Brahma wanted to discharge his own duty, but he was undone. No power was there. After that, I already told you yesterday. So after that, from the naval portion of Supreme Lord, Garbhodak Sai Vishnu, one, you know, Padma coming out, lotus flower. And Brahma discovered himself this way, Brahma, you know, Brahma, you know, Maitriya Muni now speaking so many things. This way there was, you know, big flood, only water and all water all around. What to do? Only one Padma, lotus flower, Brahma sitting, looking around, really? Everywhere water. Who am I? What to do? Where from I am coming? What is my duty? I cannot do anything. Brahma. Now after I already told you some kind of aerial instruction got tapa tapa tapa. After that, Brahma wanted to concentrate in himself. After that, after strong meditation, astute and finances, he got the facility, he cleared his eyes, this he can see well. So nice, the Supreme Lord. Eh? You know. After that, he could see everything, you know. This way, you see, Krishna, you know, Brahma, now you see, watch, Brahma, now in front of Supreme Lord, praying, so that I can discharge my duty, I can do some, you know, srishti, creation. How to do, hey Prabhu? Brahma now giving, you know, praying in front of Supreme Lord. Their stotra is there. Gyato osi me adyo suchirat nono deho bhajan na gyayate bhagavato goti rityavadyam nanyat nanyat tad asti bhagavan opi tanno sudhyam maya guno vati karad jadurubhi jadurur vibhasi. Ninth chapter, first slok. Gyato si me adyo suchirat nonu devayam na gyayate bhagavato goti rityavadyam. After long time of bhajan, Astitian Piman says, now somehow I could realize what is your, you know, instruction, what is your... So now I want to do. Nataho param param jad bhavataho sarupam anandamatram abhikalpam abhidvarshah. Nataho param param jad bhavataho sarupam anandamatram abhikalpam abhidvarshah. Pasyami visvasrijo mekam avishyamatmanah bhutendriyatmakam adasta upasritosmi tadva idam bhavana mangala mangalayo dhyanesmano darshitam ta upasakanam tasmai namo bhagavate anu vidhemo tubhyam jo anadrito naruko bhagavira sat prasangai. Actually those were only waiting for logical interpretation. Those were only running for logical interpretation. I already told the logical interpretation cannot stand in the way of their absolute truth. Many times I told you, you can remember. Logical interpretation cannot stand in the way of their absolute truth. Be careful. So now Prabhu speaking, you know, those who are already fighting with your tattva, you are there or not there, is there existence of Supreme Lord there? Actually they are, you know, they are going to hell. But anyway, out of my, you know, fastidy and finances, you show me your beautiful feature, you see? Your sarup. I'm very happy, actually. So now, actually, give me inspiration. I like to discharge my duty, I have some karma. Karma mean? That karma is not material karma. Is it? If some karma is there inside the heart of one pure devotee, it must be by the desire of Krishna. Krishna wants to get it fulfilled by that otherwise. Now Brahma going on speaking this nice way, you see. Vamastava, this prayer. I am speaking all about this prayer. Ahanya pritartha karana nishini shayana nana manurato dhiya khana bhagana nidra daiva atartha rachana risayo opi deva jismad prasanga vimukha iha sansaranti jismad prasanga vimukha iha sansaranti. 10 9th kind chapter. Ahanya pritartha karana nishini sayana nana manurata dhiya khana bhagana nidra daiva hatartha rachana risayo pi deva yusmad prasanga vimukha iha sansaranti. Those who are averse to you, actually they are coming in this material world. What Brahma speaking? Those who are averse to you, those who are less interested about you, they are actually come in this material world. They are put there already, they are actually put it into this material world. Otherwise, iha sansaranti means they are coming in this material world and living their material life. Those who are averse to you, those who don't like to do anything. Yusmad prasanga vimukha iha sansaranti. They are put it in this material world. And actually, those who are, you know, material people, they are taking so much initiative day and night. In the night time, they are full of tension. They are full of tension and anxiety. Night time, they are sometimes taking rest. And in dream, they find some, you know, problem. They shout. You know, they shout in dream. Whole day they are doing, and they are getting some reaction in you know, sleep also. Fighting with each other, you know. Suppose he is giving some 1 lakh rupees or 2 lakh rupees, you know, loan to somebody. That man not giving. So big fighting going on. Say in dream he said, "Hey, you must give my money." In dream he is speaking. This way, their sound sleep is disturbed. You know, daiva hatartha rachana risayo pi deva. They are trying to do so many things, but they are not getting result because result is not there up in their hand. Result Krishna can give. In Gita, Bhagavan also speaking. Karmanne vadhikaraste na phaleshu kadachana. Krishna speaking in Gita. Karmanne vadhikaraste. You have your duty, you have your right to do, discharge your duty. But don't think about the result, what you are going to get. Because result is not in your hand. It can be given, granted by me. Karmanni vadhikaraste ma phalesu kadachana. Don't try to expect any result. Then you can lead your fruitive action, you can go. So, they are doing so much action, they are taking, their initiative. But the result, sometimes they are not getting, because result coming from up. So, ahanya pritattakarana nishinishayana nana manorata diya khanabhagna vigna khanabhagna nidra. In dream they, you know, they break their sound sleep and they are disturbed. Somebody wanted to kill, I can kill you if you don't give my money. I can kill you, my share you have to give. In dream, he is like to kill me. In dream he is watching. This way all kind of different kind of problem coming. Nobody can take rest properly. Only by the mercy of Krishna and Guru Vaishnava, you can get total mercy of your life. Full. Then many times I told this sloka, Brahmana was speaking, Prabhu, Tvam bhakti yoga paribhavita hit saroj asase shutekshita patanonana tupungsam jad jad dhiyatu uruva urugaya vibhavayati tat tad bapu panayase sadanu grahayo. What slok? Tvam bhakti yoga paribhavita hit saroj asase sutekshita pato nanuna tupungsam yad yad dhiya ta urugaya vibhavayati tat tad vapu pranayase sadanu gruhayo tvam bhakti yoga paribhavita hit saroj asase sutekshita pato nanuna tupungsam. Very important slok. Tvam you, he Supreme Lord, you, when out of strong devotion, bhakti, yoga, paribhavita, hitsarojo, asase, inside your heart, those are pure devotees, they are doing bhakti, strong devotion. You can, actually, you can come and sit inside your heart, they can see. Our Supreme Lord coming inside your, my heart, they can see. Tvam bhakti yoga paribhavita hissarojo asase. Asase. According to Shutekshita Pungsham. This is very important slok. Shutekshita Pungsham mean, first of all, be careful. Attention, please. Shutekshita Pungsham mean, Shuto. Shuto mean, first you will have to hear. Then you can see. First of all, you have to depend upon the speech of Guru Vaishnava. You can go on hearing and render service, do go on doing service, then you can get realization, get the eyes to see. That's why first Shuto, Shuto Kriya means hearing, after then Ikshan, Ikshan means to see. Ikshan means to see. So it is written, very nice. Very nice it is. So sutekshita patanonuna to pungsam. Those are material people, they can see you through hearing of Harikatha. They can develop, they can clean their heart. Ultimately they can get that kind of, you know, power to see Krishna. Oh Supreme Lord. Yadi yadi dhiyato uruga yavibhavayati. Tattadvapu pranayase sadanu gruhayu. Sadmana sadhu, to give total facility, anugraha, anugraha mercy. If suppose, I told you one example, Tulsidas ji Maharaj is a great devotee. He is now doing bhajan in Vrindavan, where near Gopeshwar Mahadev. And one day, Krishna Bhagavan coming in front of Tulsidas ji. Tulsidas, I come for you. Prabhu is crying and paying dandavat. Prabhu, I am very happy. But one request I have. What request? Actually, my Ishtadev is Ramchandra. I like to see you in the form of Ram. Could you please take the trouble to show me? Yes, why not? Then Krishna Sarup vanish. Ramchandra coming in front of Tulsidasji Maharaj. Now he is very happy. Prabhu, you are so merciful. So you see, you can remember I already told in, you know, other mom, you know, during Gaur Purnim. Barahadev, one Brahman, he is always worshipping Kolodiv. One day Barahadev coming. Like cloud. Hey, what do you want? Eh? So nice? This way, you see, any devotee can take darshan of his Ishtadev according to his heart. Like I already told you, Mahaprabhu speaking to Mahaprabhu requesting, Mahaprabhu giving, Murari to Murari, you must do Krishna bhajan. Krishna is all attractive. Well, I can try. Whole night thinking, Prabhu, I cannot. I already sell my head unto the lotus feet of Ram. I cannot take me my head out of that. Prabhu is very satisfied. Yes, that kind of tenacity should be there. I wanted to test you actually. You are the eternal servant of Ramachandra. What problem? I am very happy. So, Tvam bhakti yoga paribhavita hissarojo asase sutekshita patano nunat pungsam yad jad dhiyat urugaya vibhavayati tat tat bapu pranayase sadanu gruhayo. When Prabhu, he wanted to give, want to give full mercy, bestow, then those sadhu, they can see their respective Ishtadev. you manifest your own, you know, sarup in front of them according to their own expectation, desire. You know, so is I'm very happy that you are, you know, nati prasidati tato pachito pacharve raradhitaha suraganir hidivadya kamai. Nati prasidati tato pachito upacharve raradhitaha suraganir hidivadya kamai. Yat sarva bhuta dayaya sadalabhyaiko nana janeshu abahitaha suhidantaratma. Prabhu speaking, actually Brahma speaking, Prabhu, if those demigods, even those demigods, if they have some, you know, karma inside the heart, then if they are worshipping you are not satisfied with them. You are very neutral personality. Nati prasidati tathopachito upacharraradhitaha suragane hridibaddha kama. If they have some kama inside their heart, demand, if they are worshipping you at all, then you are not satisfied with them, demigods. What to speak more? You see, you know, suhidantaratma. Actually, your mercy, those who are not devotee, those who are not actually devotee, they cannot get your, you know, mercy. It's not possible. You are most impartial personality, neutral personality. No partiality is there with Supreme Lord. You know, this way, Brahma speaking so nicely, praying, so nice stotra, I can go mad if I go on speaking so much. After that, you know, Brahma speaking, Prabhu, I can remember how I was created. Janna vipadma bhavanad. Janna vipadma bhavanad. Ahamasamidyo. Lokotrayopakarano jadanu grahena. Tasmai. You know, tasmai namaste udaro sabhavayo yogo nidravasano vikasat nali nekshanayo. Here is one printing mistake. Tasmai namanti hove na. Tasmai namaste, maybe. Jannabhi padma bhavanad aham asam idyo. He idyo mean ho pujaniyo. Idyo mean as the object of our worship, you are worshipable. Yannabhi padmat, mane from Nabi Neval, when Padma was there, lotus flower, and the, you know, he, you know, Prabhu, I took birth. And, you know, this way, you know, this way, you see, now speaking, you know, creation, you see, took place gradually. Udarastha bhavayo, when actually everything was there. Not that for this creation, this ingredient came from outside. Not that the ingredients for this creation not came from outside. It is like a spider. Spider, you know? Spider out of his styline, you know, is making the spider network. After the, you know, his job is over, he eat up everything. Janna vipadma bhavanat aham asam idyo lokotraya upakarana jadana. Lokotraya upakarana means this world, you know, upakarana means ingredient. Everything is done by you, in you, for you. In case ending, what's you? Jasmin jenu jatu yasu jasmai yad yad yatha yada, everything. What, for, why, when, how, everything you can ultimately. So you see, that's why You, you know, here Brahma speaking, lokotrayo upakarano jadana grahena is actually in, you know, the stem. Brahma sitting in lotus flower, but the stem, it says there is a place of 14 world. Bhur, bhuva, maho, yano, and tapo, satya, all. And all down? Atal, vital, talatal, patal, so all down. Or seven, 14 words. Yeah. The stem itself is the, you know, place where this material world created. So everything, you know, all demigods and everything, you know, and they came, follow, you see, all demigods, they came, they took their respective responsibilities. But one thing is very important, this is, you know, Martalok, Devidam. Devidam, you see, and upside, Tapo, Maha, Satyalok, it is not created every time. Be careful. There is three kind of, you know, destruction. Destruction not all same. Prakritik pralay, naimittik pralay, you know, different kind of, you know, nitya pralay, naimittik pralay, and prakritik pralay. Nitya pralay means nitya. Be careful about this siddhanta, very careful. Three kind of destruction always going on. Nobody can hear. One kind is nitya pralay. Nitya pralay? Nitya pralay means each and every fraction of second. Each and every fraction of second changing going on. Your body, this matter, material world, you know, each and every fraction of second, all your material world changing. Changing mean? Pralay. All your body cell also, blood cell, body cell, this, you know, sand and bricks, everything, all cell is there. Atom is there. Oh, changing. Oh, in me. Those trees, you know, beast, water, you know, water also changing. Everything changing. So everything changing. You know, this is called Nitya Pralay. Nitya Pralay means? Without any interval, always comes some kind of destruction going on, but you cannot feel. You cannot feel. If somebody watching you after 10 years, he can buy, you look so old today. Before 10 years, I saw you, so nice figure, now you are growing old. But you are looking your own figure, in mirror, you cannot, you know, distinguish the difference. You see. So now, Nitya Pralay is this kind of every fraction of second without any, you know, stoppage. Always going on, this kind. You cannot feel. And all universe, even inside your body, mind, everything going on. This is called Nitya Pralay. Another Naimittik Pralay. Naimittik Pralay means, Naimittik Pralay means actually to destroy these three worlds, Tribhuvan, Sargamatya Patal. You know, this way. But be careful, upper world actually, they are Maharjana, Tapo, this loka not always created and destructive. Because this loka is excellent place. Not that this place is also, you know, destroyed and again created, not that. For some and certain period, it is fixed up. Not that Naimittik Pralay cannot disturb that place. You know? Follow what I say. It's not disturbed all the time. Have some interval. Pati kalpete tahayana. In every kalpa, it is not changed. That's fixed. After kalpa, they can change. So that time, what happens actually? Sankarshan. How Naimittik Pralay take place? How and when? When Sankarsan Prabhu become agitated, then from Sankarsan mouth, then fire coming for destroying the whole world. air is called actually Naimittik Praloy. So whole world is, you know, burnt up by the fire of Sankarshan. Is called actually Naimittik Praloy. And how Prakritik Praloy? Prakritik Praloy how took place? I already told you, cannot remember. I already told many times I am speaking, you cannot remember. Creation is like unfolding the mystery. Like one big folding paper is there. First fold, second fold, third fold, fourth fold, fifth fold, total. So you see, from seed, nothing is there. I already told, all everything in balanced condition. Chaturajatama, no creation is there. It's like seed. After all folding, opening. One by Mahatatya, this, that, Ahangtatya, this, that, all the. And while destruction going on, then total Naimit, 12 Prakritik Praloy, then reverse way, vice versa. Then all the, you know, the present cause going and going to submerge with the just previous cause. That previous cause just going to submerge with the just previous cause. This way they are going back. Back and back and back and back and back and back. And then ultimately they are going west. This way, Prakritik Praloy. Follow my point? Understand? This knowledge which Supreme Lord giving to you by me should spray all over the world. You should understand. This way actually, so Brahma, you know, this way you see. Maitreya, now Brahma was, you know, praying. Stotra I already told so long. After that, Maitreya again speaking in front of Vidruji Maharaj, how this creation going on, how Brahma was created, how different Kal Nirupan, Kal time, how time came, and the division of time, and Yuga how created, Manantar how created, you know, this way, different kind of creation, and you know, Brahma how created human beings, how the beast and trees and everything, those, you know, different kind of, you know, Gandharva, or, you know, different kind of creature, how created by Brahma, oh, Maitreya Muni, and this way speaking all about this. Now one point coming. This is a creation. Everything a total explanation given by Maitreya to see how this creation took place. But in the meantime, one sequence, one condition is there. But when creation and a creation not going up, Brahma cannot expedite. He cannot give some acceleration to this creation. My rapid speed of creation not taking place. What to do? I wanted to create so fast actually. It's so slow. Nobody helping me. Then what Brahma done? Then Brahma meditate. After that, Brahma from his own body create one male and female. Manu and Satrupa. The first man. Manu, Manus. This name came from Manu. Manus. This name, in Bengali Sanskrit, Manushaha. You know, the Sanskrit also Manus. Nara. Nara means Manus also. So this is, you know, this name came from Manu, this Manush. So after that, Sutta, actually, here we find, and Brahma first is, he is undone, he cannot create properly. I am giving backside thing, I am speaking first. Is the backside thing. Brahman of creation is, actually, the creation not going fast. So Brahma first create first man and woman, Manu and Satrupa. Manu and Satrupa actually got some order from Brahma. Brahma, Pitamaha, give us order. Hey, you carry out my order. Because my order is not my order. I am also giving order by Supreme Lord for creation. Okay, I am ready to help you. But how to do? Why? You can go to earth, world. Earth is there, you can... But earth is not there. Why? Earth is there? Prabhu, Pita, earth already gone to water. Water? During creation, I found water everywhere. I drink up all the darkness and water. I drink up. Where from this water again coming? I don't know. Where from water coming? We don't know. How I can carry out water? There is no place to, you know, to go on with creation. This creation, how, where I can do? No place. The earth already gone to water. Water? Then Vidurji Maharaj, in the meantime, actually, Shukadev Goswami going, speaking to Parikshit Maharaj, and that quotation spoken by Shukadev Goswami to Sanakadi Rishi, in between the sequence coming, that Vidurji Maharaj speaking to Vidurji Maharaj and Maitreya Muni speaking. You should keep track, very attention. Otherwise, you know, now Vidurji is speaking his own feeling. Very nicely in front of Maitreya Gurudev. Gurudev, sutasya pungsam suchira samasya nanjo sasurir vrita artho tattad gunanu sabanam mukundo padarvinda hidaye sujesham. Speaking, sutasya pungsam suchira samasya nanjo sasurir vrita artho tattad gunanu sabanam mukundo padarvindam hidaye sujesham. 13th chapter, 4th sloka. Sutasya pungsam suchiro samasyo nonu anjasa suribir ririta artho tattad gunan sabanam mukunda padar vinda hidesh jesam. Viduji Maharaj speaking. We can read Ved Vedanta Sruto. Sutasya pungsam suchiro. A man can take trouble to go through Veda a long time. So many Vedas, you see. For long time putting energy. But still he cannot get results so easily. Sutasya pungsam suchiro samasya nonu anjasa suribir suribir rita artho. But you can get the ultimate result. What for you are reciting Veda? Why? What is your reason? What do you want? You want Supreme Lord? You cannot get ready-made result. But if you go through the glories of pure Guru Vaishnav, those who are keeping Krishna inside their heart, if you glorify their name, then instantly Krishna can come and see you. You can get the result very quickly. Sutasya pungsam suchira samasya. Sutasya pungsam suchira samasya. Nanyo sasurivir irita artho. Tatyad gunan sabanam kunda. Padarabhinda hidaye sujesam. Those pure Sadhguru Vaishnav, those who are keeping Krishna inside their heart and locking. Krishna cannot go out, you can sit inside my heart. That kind of pure Guru Vaishnav, if you can glorify their name and fame, then readily Krishna can come and sit inside your heart. No need of taking any trouble to go through Veda, Vedanta. So much time, your body not working, you cannot get up 4 o'clock or 3 o'clock. A sadhu when get up? 2 o'clock. 2:10, 2:11, 2 o'clock, but we cannot get up and attend Harikatha. So weak we are. Very weak. You know, sutasya pungsam suchiro samasya nonu anjasa suri bhirita artho tattad gunanu sabanam mukundo padarvinda hideshu jesham. Bhaktivinoda Thakur used to do Harinam whole night, taking rest for only 2 hours, two hours. Only taking rest, you know, maybe 9 o'clock, 11 o'clock, get up and sit, doing Harinam. Until and unless you get that kind of power, no kind of siddhi you can get. Siddhi means bhakti siddhi. You cannot get. Tremendous affinity. Satsanga and asatsanga parallel going on. You are coming, attending Harikatha, doing, also doing, অস অসৎসঙ্গে অসহ গো দুধও খাবো তামাকও খাবো। প্রভুপাদ স্পিকিং সো নাইসলি, প্রভুপাদ ইজ ওয়ান সন অফ এ ল্যান্ডলর্ড, হ্যাঁ, হি ইজ এ নো হি ডেভেলপ টিবি ইউনো টিউন নো ওয়ান কাইন্ড অফ ডিজিজ, ব্লাড কামিং আউট ফ্রম চেস্ট, টিবি টিউবারকুলোসিস। The Jamindar, he is a son of Jamindar. Now Jamindar is very anxious. If somebody knowing my son is tuber, everybody can laugh. So very secretly he wanted to arrange some treatment, proper treatment. He called one nice Ayurvedic doctor, very expert. He came in. I'm sitting with, you know, that son. Hey, how you develop this kind of doctor? I don't know. You don't know? You come with me secret place in front of father, not speaking. Do you drink or smoke? Speak rightly. Yes, a little bit. Little bit? You drink. From today, I can start my treatment. But you cannot take any liquor, no smoking, nothing. I can give medicine and nice, you know, food, protein, and cheese and milk, curd. I can give you. Be careful. Don't try to. I know. Don't try to do this thing anymore. Then father thinking, what condition with my son? Our condition is bad, but still he can recover if you obey me. Then what kind of prescription you have? I can give this kind of prescription in front of you, all medicine, everything. But the son, while doctor going away outside room, he's running. Doctor, I have a request. What request? I already told you. Yes, I am going to obey you. But well, you, if you can permit me to smoke and drink, I can also take medicine. I am not going. Then I cannot. I cannot give treatment to you. You like to both take medicine and go. You know how I can give treatment? This kind of treatment. I cannot give treatment to you all. You are asasanga. You are doing also coming here for asasanga. How I can save you? Not possible. Only you will have to do satsanga. Fraction of second in your life, you cannot go for a satsanga. Be careful. Otherwise, I have no medicine for you. So now actually, you know, Brahma speaking, Prabhu. Manu requesting in front of Brahma, "Oh Father, I am ready to carry out your order, but you will also have to give some facility." What kind of facility? I already give. No. Here's a pool of water, earth gone. Brahma now say, "How is that possible? I already saw problem. Earth was there. How it go under Rasatal? It's big problem. What to do? How to do?" Brahma now thinking very strongly. It's a question of anxiety. In the meantime, one Barahadev coming out, sneezing, and from nasal hole, Baraha coming, like mosquito fast, with sneezing, then coming out. After that, in front of Brahma, is growing up. Mosquito, like mosquito coming. After that, rat. After that, you know, goat. After the pig, weep. Then Brahma singing, what's that? It must be Supreme Lord. Other, how is possible? Oh, Prabhu. Then started praying. Then you see, that Barahadev jump into the water and go and get the world, you see, two teeth there, with teeth, this earth is taking up world. Taking out of Rasatal from water, the Barahadev put it in this static condition in space and vanish. In the meantime, when Barahadev appear, all rishis there praying, "Oh Prabhu, Jitam jitam te ajita yogya bhavana trayim tanum sam paridhunvate namaha yadrom garte su lililyur adhyo lililyur লীলীয়র অধ্যয় যস্তস্মৈ নমো কারণ সুকরায়তে হ্যাঁ দিস ওয়ে দে আর অ্যাকচুয়ালি প্রেইং নমো নমস্তে অখিল তন্ত্র দেবতা দ্রব্যায় সর্বক্রতবে ক্রিয়াত্মনে বৈরাগ্য ভক্তাত্ম জয়ানু ভাবিত ভাবিত জ্ঞানায় বিদ্যা গুরবে নমো নমঃ অ্যাকচুয়ালি ইজ যজ্ঞপুরুষ ওয়েন ব্রহ্মা ইজ 13 চ্যাপ্টার আই এম স্পিকিং 34 শ্লোক অ্যান্ড 39 অ্যাকচুয়ালি অল যজ্ঞা ওয়াজ পসিবল বাই বরাহদেব বরাহদেব গোয়িং আউট অফ ওয়াটার অ্যান্ড শেক ইজ বডি দিস ওয়ে অ্যান্ড ফ্রম বডি সাম ইউ নো ফেত লোম গোয়িং আউট দেন কুশ অ্যান্ড কাস কুশ অ্যান্ড কাস ইউনো কুশ আসন ইউনো হ্যাঁ উইদাউট কুশ অ্যান্ড কাস উই ক্যান নট স্টার্ট এনি যজ্ঞা So by the you know mercy of Varahadev now it's possible for us to go for yagya so dangstra bolche so dangstra agro kachya bhagavan staya dhritya vairayate bhudharo bhu sa bhudhara yatha banat nisrito banat নিঃসরতো দতা ধৃতা মতঙ্গ গজেন্দ্রস্য সপত্রোপদ্দিনী লাইক ওয়ান এলিমেন্ট এলিফেন্ট সামটাইম এন্টার ইন দ্য ফরেস্ট অফ পাদ্যা পদ্ম ফুল সামটাইম ওয়ান এলিফেন্ট মে ক্রেজি এলিফেন্ট রানিং অ্যান্ড এন্টারিং ইন টু দ্য ফরেস্ট অফ পদ্মা পদ্মা ইউ নো লোটাস আর হোয়াট ইজ পদ্মা ইজ ভেরি ডেলিকেট অ্যান্ড এলিফেন্ট ইজ ভেরি ইউ নো জাস্ট অপোজিট So doing jostling, after that Padma become distorted, you know, Padma, the situation is very bad. Like that mad elephant, Supreme Lord, jumping into water, and the wave, so wave, because Supreme Lord, the cause of all cause, jumping into water, and going inside, and getting this earth with two teeth, going up, and putting this earth up, just like an elephant entering into Padma Ban. And Maitreya Muni now giving example, so now in the meantime, you see, this way, Adi Daitya, Hiranyaksha was killed. But we are surprised, how you know Hiranyaksha is killed? Because that time when Manu and Brahma thinking about this, that time no question of No question of Hiranyaksha. Hiranyaksha didn't took place. Where from is coming? Because long after in the destiny of, you see, you know, because the Varaha avatar, we can discuss about two Varaha. One is said Varaha Kalpya, Swayambhuva Manantara Jagyamurti Varaha, and another Chakshush Manantara, another Manantara. When from Dakhya, you see, Diti Aditi, you see? After that, the question of, you know, son, daughter of Dakhya is Diti Aditi. Then Aditi and Diti got married with Kardam. Kashyap. Kardam is separate. Kardam is get married with Devahuti. So now, where from this Varaha the question coming? Now no question of Varaha avatar? Yes, two-time Varaha avatar. Be careful. Siddhanta is so topmost. One Varaha, he just appear and jump into water and they deliver this earth, set the earth free and disappear. Another Varaha, that Varaha came from the nozzle, whole of Brahma. Another Varaha who fight with, you know, Hiranyaksha, that Varaha is actually Chakshush Manantar. Follow, you can follow my point. Yeah? This way actually, see, we can see two kind of varaha actually we can see. Now we come to this point. First varaha avatar I am discussing about how came from the took birth on the nasal hole of Brahma. Now the sequence we are, you know is different. Now we want to discuss this point, how Diti develops the womb. Diti. It is 14th chapter, Sukvacho. Actually, this Maitreya Muni, while discussing about this Varaha Dev Bhagavan, while he is speaking, he is speaking all together. He is not speaking separately. He is speaking Varaha Avatar took place and Hiranyaksha fighting with Varaha, and after that Hiranyaksha was killed. This Maitreya Muni was so deep absorbing condition, he was narrating Bhagavad and he forget to speak these two separately. Okay, no problem. But now Tikaka, those who are giving commentary, Vishwanath Chakravarti and all the big commenter, they are the near and dear on of Krishna, personal associate of Krishna. They are giving direction, but actually that time, no question of Hiranyaksha. Hiranyaksha not yet appeared. How possible? So this way, we are getting, solution, So now question coming, how Diti got Hiranyaksha, Hiranyaksha in his own womb? How? My situation is very, situation is very dangerous. One day, actually, Maitreya Muni is speaking. One day, actually, Diti is feeling so disturbed. She wanted to get the association of husband very immediately now. The husband is thinking, you will have to wait for some time because it's evening time, it's not good. It's not auspicious time, you see. So you'll have to wait. Kashyap requesting wife, you will have to wait for some time. I love you so much, but I cannot, No, I want, children. Okay, I can arrange, but you will have to wait. No, I cannot wait. Then Kashyap Muni thinking, maybe it is the arrangement of Supreme Lord. Otherwise, how it is possible I am doing bhajan in my bhajan kutir, doing the last fire sacrifice to get to complete my 2 days bhajan. At the moment, he is disturbing me. Well, let us go. Then after that, association. Then Kashyap Muni taking bath in water and thinking about this Brahman. Hey Prabhu, excuse me, because I was not ready. By you, I think maybe some inspiration is there. Oh, we can see after what result. In the meantime, when you take bath and come into Bhajan Kutir, Diti crying, excuse me, I have done mistake, you forbid. You repeatedly told this is not the time for association, but still I was restless, please excuse me. But what to speak? Kashyap Muni is speaking, you are begging for excuse, but already done, mistake done. I cannot do anything. Mistake done already. Anyway, you are going to get very dangerous children, who is just fearful for the whole world. Oh my God, I have done some mistake. I already told. Evening time, Shankar Bhagavan traveling here and there. This is not the appropriate time. You can expect from me that kind of behavior is not good. But you have done mistake, what to do? I told you. Now you will have to get the result. No excuse. No excuse, no respite. You will have to give result for that. What to do? She is crying. Well, you can get one grandson. Whole world can, come and pray dandavat to your grandson. His name is Prahlad Maharaj Ki Jai. Is Prahlad Maharaj. For your grandson, everything can be solved. He is so great devotee. So his great devotee. So his great, facility you can get. So he is going to do great bhajan, nicely. As I know, this way Diti and now develop his womb, and day is coming to give birth. But the demigods, they are very disturbed. They are feeling, going to Brahma. Who Brahma? Who Pitamaha? What problem happened? We are feeling some disturbance everywhere. All our power gone. Oh, sunlight also very poor. Huh? Why? In front of Brahma, those demigods saying, what's the problem? Actually, you can go, no problem actually. Actually, Diti, she is going to give birth to two big demons actually. Their power is so high, so their teja, this, their influence is so high, so from inside womb, they are putting some influence. So when they can take birth, what problem can happen, you see, now? What problem they can create? Those demigods, you see, the demigods then gone and waiting for time. And in the meantime, Diti now already give birth to two boys. I mean, twin baby. One is, you see, Hiranyaksha, another is Hiranyakasipu. And, you know, Hiranyakasipu is a big Adidaitya, big demon. Is so power, super power. They can use a big, big hill, big, big, you know, mountain. They can go and fist, crash in front of Varun. Go, hey Varun, I heard you are very powerful. Come and I like to fight you. Brim Varun looking, who is Adidaitya? Actually, I am very poor. I cannot fight with you. You can fight with right man. Where is he? You can find him in water, actually. He can come in front of you someday, very shortly. And you have to lie down in battlefield. You have to lie, leave your body very shortly. Oh, really? I also seeking that kind of powerful, mighty man. I am mighty man, I also want the second one. So that I can have a nice chance of fight with him and get a, you know, nice feeling of fighting. Where he is? Very shortly you can meet him. Varunde very politely. Because there is demon. He's demon. Varunde is very humble. Varunde is so powerful. Actually, I have no power to fight with you. You can search out your match, own matching. You can come. There's waiting. Where I can get? He's searching. In the meantime, you see? You know, in the meantime, you see? He is searching this way, everywhere going, sometimes going to heaven. Eh? This way, you see, suddenly, you see, he find, searching here and there, he find one animal there. Animal means Barahav Bo. Pig, Barahadev. Hey, what is that? Who are you? From where you are coming? He is coming in water. Hey, where you are going? To get what? Actually, is going to search earth. First earth, you see, delivered. Second time gone. Then again. But that time, the fighting took place with, you know, that time, fighting took place with Barahadev, Hiranyaka fighting. Hey, you are a beast. Like, you know, what do you want? This way speaking all rubbish against Supreme Lord. Supreme Lord is speaking. Actually, Supreme Lord also giving answer. Actually, Hiranyaka speaking. He also said Deva Uchi. This way, they are also giving answer to each other. Very rough, very rudely, very roughly, this Hiranyaka speaking against Supreme Lord. He don't know his Supreme Lord. He thought he is Banogoshara, is an animal. Where from you? Where you are going? Hey, this world given by Brahma to us. Why you are touching this? Look, leave. I can kill you. Then after the fighting going on. Now point is that, you know, question coming, where from these two Hiranyakasipu coming? What is the reason? What is the reason? Maitreya Muni is speaking. There actually is a long history. What history? Bhaja, one time in past, long ago, the son of, first son of Brahma, sons, Chatusan, Sananda, Sananta, Sanat Kumar, they all, you know, in a group, they, you know, got information from Brahma, they got clue from Brahma, they got clue about Supreme Lord. So they wanted to, they hear from Brahma. So first of all, they was, they were worshipping impersonal Brahma, they are nirvishesh Brahma, formless Brahma. They first of all, in their previous life, my previous life, first stage of life. But now, when they heard about from about Supreme Lord from Brahma, Father, they got interested, then we must go to Vaikuntha Loka to take darshan. We are interested. Then they go. When they hearing Harikatha from Brahma, they become devotee. They interested to take darshan of Prabhu. They going to Brahma. They are going to Vaikuntha. And in Vaikuntha, there are so many gates. First gate, second gate, third gate, both. They are, you know, crossing one gate. They are entering one gate, another gate, another gate. After that, final gate, you see, there was Joy and Vijay, the gate man. Joy and Vijay, the gate man. Hey, where you are going? With stick. You see, you are showing your red eyes to us. You don't know what? Hey, don't go. No, we must go. Don't go. When they saw red eyes, is to Joy Vijay. Then Chatusan became very angry. Hey, how dare you speak like that? You don't know in Vaikuntha, no ordinary person can come. How we can enter Vaikuntha? That's when we can enter more inside. No! We curse you. You are like demon, you are acting. How is that possible? You are staying in Vaikuntha Loka, there is no Kunta. Vaikuntha Loka means there is no Kunta, no hesitation. But you are feeling hesitation. You don't know who we are. So you go down and take birth as demon. Fall down. I curse you, your fall down can happen in your life. Then the Joy Vijay crying, please excuse me. In the meantime, Supreme Lord, very quickly, Supreme Lord could understand some altercation going on in the gate side. He coming home very quickly with Lakshmi Devi. And Chatusan watching, that Supreme Lord is so nice, is he? Paid on the word, Prabhu, excuse us. Actually, we cursed them. Excuse us, it was not good for us. I don't know why, you know, it's big problem, excuse me. Excuse us, you know, this is a Chatusan praying in front of Supreme Lord. Supreme Lord saying, no, question of excuse. It was by my personal desire. It was my own, you know, inspiration. The incident took place. It was my arrangement. Be careful. So you are not responsible at all. Chatusan, you are not responsible. I am responsible. I wanted to get that kind of sequence, situation, so that I can send them to worldly planet. And I can have the chance to fight with them. So Joy Vijay now crying, Prabhu, how we can, you know, come back to you. Prabhu speaking, see, if positively if you think, then it will take 7 life. In negative way if you do, then it will take 3 life. What if, which one you choose? Whichever is feasible for you, you can accept. Oh no, in 3 life we like to come back. You know? Hiranyaka, Hiranyakasipu, Ravan and Kumbhakarna, Dantavarko and Shishupa. So, you see, see life. And finally, they got Kipa in Gaur Lila, this Kangsa. So, this way, finally Gauranga is all in all. We are very happy. we have the chance to come here in Gaurdham. Infinity world, no Switzerland, France, Italy, nowhere we like to go. We like to stay here in Navadvip, in Vrindavan. We don't like to go anywhere. Very nice place, you see. So this way, they fall down, you see. Now one thing happened, you see. While they are, you know, Supreme Lord coming in front of them, then Chatushan got the smell of all Tulsi and Pushpa, flower already offered into the lotus feet of, you know, Narayan. Some devotee giving. So that smell, Chatushan could get. Ah, so nice smell, Chandan and, yeah? So many, you know, Chandan, Pushpa, so many things. So here, nice Siddhanta. Even you get the smell of, you know, Chandan, Pushpa and Tulsi, already offered into the lotus feet of Krishna, then you are lucky. You know, you don't know your luck. Tasya arabinda nayana sapada arabinda kinjal kamissa tulasima karanda bayu antargataha sabibarena chakaratesam sankshobam aksharajusamupi chitta tanya bhajan tasya arabinda nayana sapada arabindam kinjal kamissa tulasi makaranda bayu antargataha sabivarena chakaratesam sankshobam aksharajusamupi chitta tanya. 43, 15th chapter. Tasyo kasyo. Tasya mean? Tasya mean kasya. Bhajan tasya arabindasya. Tasya arabindasya mean? Krishna sa Narayanasya. Yeah, Narayanasya is good because Vaikuntha. Tasya arabinda nayanasya padarabinda kinjal kamissa tulasi makaranda bhai. Mara, yeah, tasya arabindasya. Arabinda mean? Narayan. And those already, Tulsi, Chandan, and Keshar. Keshar, you know? Keshar. I am also using Keshar here. That's why Gopi Chandan become red. Keshar. You cannot allow. You cannot do. Keshar. It's little Vrindavan. From Vrindavan I got Keshar. It's very nice. So, Keshar has some kind of flavor. So, this way, so already offered unto the lotus feet of Narayan some flower, Chandan, Keshar, Tulsi. So when Narayan came in front of Chatushan, in front of Chatushan, what happens then? Then Chatushan looking at them, looking at Narayan. Lakshmi is there. But after that, they got the smell. Flower, Chandan and Tulsi offered, that smell coming. Then, he become very, you know, feeling some strong, you know, agitation inside heart. Some reaction taking place. When smell going inside, then giving some reaction. Very nice reaction. They are feeling feeling like intoxicated. Yeah. Tasya arabinda nayana sapada arabinda kinjal kamissa tulasi makaranda vayu antargataha sabivarena chakarati sam sankshobham aksharajusamo pichitta tana. Though previously they used to worship Om. Those who are Shudra and Stri, they should not utter this Om Sabda. They have no right. It is written. They have no right. They cannot speak. So, actually, Chatushan, they used to worship this word, Om. Now, when the smell coming and already heard some katha from Brahma, they gone mad. They're feeling inspiration. When smell going inside, aksharajusamupi chitta teno. They're feeling some reaction inside heart. Then Kumara Uchu, Kumara speaking so many things. After that, they find this Jay and Vijay to get man from Vaikuntha, they are falling down. They are crying and falling down. Prabhu saying, no, you should not have any tension. I bless. If positively, it will take 7 lives. If negatively, it will take 3 lives. You go. I have some desire there. I like to fulfill my desire with you all. Go. No. I can deliver you. I can go. No problem. So each time you see, Supreme Lord delivery, Ramchandra, first Varahadev, then Ramchandra, then after that Krishna. Eh? After that Krishna. So Jiva Goswami was giving Siddhanta, the final mukti can be given by Krishna. Final like that. So this way actually Hiranyakasipu took birth, how they you know fight with Varahadev, and how they fall down, all you know I speak in gist everything. Now actually fighting going on in water, and Hiranyaksha you know fighting with Varahadev, and all demigods they are you know with you know tension, full of tension, they are watching from high. After that Varahadev with you know, put here. Oh, that were all you know blood coming like you know, and Varahadev were looking very nice, blood coming here, this there. And all Deva Uchu, Deva, this Dimigo, they are also praying, oh Prabhu, you have done rightly. Ah, we all very happy. Because that demon used to put us in trouble. Us all in trouble all the time. We are feeling so much tension for a long time. No solution. Today we find solution. Very nice. Prabhu. And now they are actually praying to Supreme Lord Prabhu. Very nicely they are praying in front of Supreme Lord. After that you see, after that you see, there is a creation going on, chain wise, from, because earth was delivered, then Manu and Satrupa, then after that from Manu and Satrupa you can see everything created. From Manu and Satrupa, all creation, creation going on, gradually. First you know, Manu got, you know, who? The mother of Kapil Dev, Devahuti, Akuti Prasuti Devahuti, Akuti Ruchaye, Prasuti, has given to Daksha. This way you see, all they are in their destiny, they are child, children, they are, you know, growing creation. Now I come to the point, Jay Manuji Maharaj is very interested to give his daughter in marriage with Kardam Rishi, Devahuti. Devahuti heard so many glories of, you know, Kardam Rishi. She took decision to marry Kardam Rishi. Took decision to marry Kardam Rishi. In the meantime, Kardam Rishi doing bhajan. Kardam Rishi bhajan, doing bhajan. Very nice bhajan. And someday Supreme Lord giving order, hey, you will have to go for marriage. And the daughter of Manu, Devahuti. Anyway, Manu is coming shortly to you, in front of you, to give this daughter in your hand. Be careful. It is my desire. Try to accept. Try to accept. Then actually Kardam Rishi doing bhajan, got the instruction of Supreme Lord, waiting. After that, he find one plane coming. Plane means Biman. Chariot. In chariot, who is there? Manu, Satrupa and daughter Devahuti. coming with all articles, so many auspicious and thing. Eh? You see? And coming here in front of Kardam Rishi, paying Dandavat, Ho Rishi, we are coming in front of you, we have some desire. What desire you have? Try to speak out. Already knowing, but still speaking. Kardam Rishi already got information from some Lord. What for you are coming? Actually, my daughter, she want to marry you. Is the arrangement of Supreme Lord, you must accept, because you also like to enter into graceful life, a heart. Yes, you are right. Well, she is the fittest person, you know, lady, I can accept. Okay. Because actually, she got inspiration from Naradji. Naradji is speaking so many glories about you. So from then onward, she took decision to marry you. Nobody else. So what to do? Oh, nothing else, I can marry, no problem. After the marriage took place, then actually, marriage took place, actually big marriage, the hilly place, you know. Nice. After that, so many rishis, munis, they are coming to enjoy. After that, you know, Manu Maharaj crying. She cannot bear the separation of daughter. She is embracing and crying. Oh, my daughter, you stay here. Do give service to your husband. It's very nice, you know, this way. Sometime you can come to me. I can also come. So don't cry anyway. That's why, you see, this way, Kardam and Devahuti got married. This way, after that, and Kardam received promise in front of Devahuti, see, so long as one son not coming here in our family life, till then I can stay here, after that he will have to leave me. I can go away. I can wait till one son appear in our in a family life. Till then I can wait. After that you cannot stop me going. Well, okay. After that, they are waiting for a long time. Kardam Rishi doing bhajan, Devahuti helping. He is Rajkanna, the daughter of one big king. Manu is, I know, to a whole big emperor of the whole world. His daughter, so delicate and so fine. Still she is bound to do some seva. But Rishi doing jagya. So wife also doing something? Ascetic and pensive. So gradually she is, you know, is losing his glamour, everything. Doing bhajan, because husband doing bhajan all day. Om Swaha, Om Swaha. Husband, wife also doing in this way. So she loses health, gradually losing health, all beauty gone. Then after that one day, Kardamji is there. I am very happy with you because you are serving me without any, you know, expectation. Causeless service you are. Now let us go. I can fulfill your desire. Then Ashwini Kumar Dwaya, they are making one pond, a very Ayurvedic pond, where you take bath, you can get back your, you know, health back. Then Kardam Rishi requires him, go and take bath in this pond. You can recover your health. Very nice. Very young lady you can become. Go and take bath. After hundreds of, you know, maid servant coming, what service we can do for you? Oh, Mataji, speak us. Then after they are serving, then Kardam Rishi, out of his yoga power, making one nice plane, Biman, in which you can get all facility. Kamogo Biman. Kamogo means anywhere that Biman plane can go. Anywhere, all facility there. Not water and food. All playing ground, everything. Everything, all facility. What is not there inside the kingdom of, you know, Indra Maharaj. Mandata even gone mad, huh? Everybody gone mad. Not possible. Indra Maharaj. After that, Kardam is traveling with his wife, long time. In Sanskrit we say Bihar Kora. Bihar. And in the meantime, gradually, different at different times they are getting, you know, daughter. Nine or I forget, I have to check up. I forget. So daughter coming. So after that, they actually, Kadambisi wanted to go to forest. Then Devahuti crying, you promised me, till then you can stay here. Huh? When we are going to get one song, because Supreme already forecast you that I am coming in the form of your son. So till then you will have to wait. Kadambisi, okay, let me wait. After that you see, Kadambisi waiting. After that you see, Kadambisi waiting. After that someday they find that, you know, after that they find, you know, they find Supreme Lord appearing at Kapil Dev in their home. Kapilji Maharaj ki jai. Kapilji Maharaj now appear and they are very happy, they are dancing, you know. Kapilji Maharaj is Supreme Lord himself going, coming. After that there are so many duties, you see. Actually Kardamji Maharaj going to give away those daughters away in marriage, where so many Rishi Muni coming, they accepting their daughter one by one. There's just some division I can speak after. Now, actually, when the son is grown up, that it is a usual rules in Indian society, Vedic society, if one Rishi getting one nice to any family man, when getting one, you know, when a boy, then when he is just enough to take responsibility of wife, I mean his mother, then it is the usual rule, they should go away from this family life, go enter forest. Usual rule, we can find all different kind of kings, Pithu Maharaj, everything, Yudhishthira Maharaj, all you can find, Angaraj, Pithu Maharaj, they all entering. Is the usual rule in Vedic society. They must enter into, you know, Vanaprastha life or sannyas, as you like. Usual rule. You cannot stay. Because anyway, it is your final, you know, goal to cut the material bondage from this material world and go away unto the lotus feet of Krishna. It's the final goal. Why you are not developing that kind of, you know, feeling? Not. So family life means you will have to go gradual promotion. First you get marriage, affinity for each other, gradually you are losing. After that also more and more losing. After that, total. I meet one, you know, husband and wife, very small age. And maybe the wife is 22 and husband is 25. They are from Bangalore. They request me, Maharaj, you can come to our house. We can arrange everything. I am not going anywhere, mother. She is speaking. Maharaj, we are enjoying your Harikatha. Actually, if you can come to Bangalore, I am not going anywhere, mother. You can come here if you like. I am not. No, nobody can touch you. Nobody can do any problem. No, I am not going here. You can come. She is saying, Maharaj, we got married long ago and gradually, now we are feeling detachment with him. We are not losing affinity for him. It's very nice. At night, 3 o'clock, I get up, and my husband, 3:30. This way, speaking all. See, oh, meet me again in, you know, Pune. When I go with our Baden Maharaj, he take me to go there, Harikatha. There, she come. She got information. Baden Maharaj coming with one Baba. It must be Sam Baba. He coming as he, I was sure, it is Sam Baba. See, dancing. Anyway, this way actually, it is the usual rule, family life, you should lose, you know, affinity with it, gradually. You must lose. Now actually, this copy, actually, this Kardam Rishi going away from this material world. He wanted to take sannyas. Sannyas. Now one big Siddhanta coming. Maharaj, why people doing bhajan? To get Supreme Lord. And whereas the Supreme Lord already appear in his room, why he is going to take sannyas? It can be a big question, very secret question, a so intricate, you know, question. What is the reason? Pratyaksha, parokha, aparoksha. Pratyaksha, gyan. Apratyaksha, you know, gyan. This kind of one kind of knowledge that you can gather with your sense organ. Another, by the backing of knowledge you can get. Some knowledge backing you, I can get realization some. But another is that, if you are put it into direct field and facing problem, then you can get. Pratyaksha, paroksha and aparoksha. Aparoksha means you doing himself and getting result. Practical. Follow, I said. So now Kardamasi took decision to go leave this material world, though he is enjoying full kippah of Supreme Lord. Already Supreme Lord coming in the form of, you know, Kapil Muni. Still he took decision to leave to get full kippah of Supreme Lord, because in forest he is going to take sannyas, directly he can get a direct feelings. He can face different kind of problem, eventualities, he can face that kind. Follow, you see? Pratyaksha, paroksha and aparoksha. Aparoksha means, aparoksha not directly, indirect. Not that. Aparoksha meaning, if you kare, if you, they meaning this is not. Aparoksha means there is no screen of maya at all, touch. Aparoksha, direct. Feeling should be direct. Not that you are gathering knowledge using your sense organ, that is not. Aparoksha doesn't mean that you are going to get some experience and knowledge using your sense organ, not that. That already I told, pratyaksha. Pratyaksha gyan. Pratyaksha gyan means you are collecting knowledge using your sense organ and brain, I mean mind, material mind and brain, all material now. Follow my point. It is very intricate question, very secret. Nowhere you can get answer. Very careful. So now point is that when Kardam Rishi, you know, going out, taking sannyas, now mother Devahuti developing so much detachment. So much determined. Now crying in front of whom? Kapil. In the meantime, I forget to speak you. There is Ananda Sarovar. Bindu Sarovar. There's an important Sarovar. At the bank of Bindu Sarovar, this Devahuti is sitting and putting question in front of Kapilji Maharaj. Now she is not thinking, he is my son, not that way. He is Supreme Lord. Oh Prabhu, please excuse me. I am a bonded soul, please save me. So, is written Maitreya Muni now speaking. Pitari prasthite aranya matuhu priya chikirsaya tasmin bindu sare avatsit bhagavan kapilo kilo. Pitari prasthite banam matuhu priyo chikirsaya tasmin bindu sare avatsir bhagavan kapilo kila. When father gone, then Kapilji started doing bhajan at the bank of Bindu Sarovar. Mother coming, paying dandavat. Oh, Supreme Lord, I know you are not my son. You came in the form of my son. Are you actually Supreme Lord? Nirvinya nitaram bhuman asad indriya tarshada jeno samya samanena prapanya andham tamah prabhu nirvinya nitaram bhuman asad indriya tarshanat jeno samya samanena prapanya andham tamah prabhu. I fall down into maya, darkness, You save me, save me. I can explain this sloka tomorrow. Nirvinya nitaram bhuman asat indriya tarshanat jeno sambhasya manena prapanya andham tamaha prabhu agyanati virandasa gyananjana sarakya chakshuru minitam jeno tasmisya agyan. I am bringing it. So this sloka is very important. Actually, is a number 7 sloka in, you know, 25th chapter. It's very important, actually. Nibritta nitaram bhuman asad indriya darsanat jeno sambhasya manena prapanya andham tamaha prabhu.